Hi, this is Kristen.
This is Nate the Unicorn.
And this is Booth TV. Enjoy.
Best camera.
This is GBC. Remakes and beats, doing what we please. Freedom the beats and smash up all enemies. This is GBC. Remakes and beats, jumping MCs. Freedom beef and beat up all enemy MCs. This is GBC. Remakes and beats, doing what we please. Freedom the beats and smash up all enemies. This is GBC. Remakes and beats, jumping MCs. Freedom beef and beat up all enemy MCs.
It's a throwback. We so stacked with the whole pack. And don't rasp, hold back. You let it go, crack upside your head. Already told you back the fuck up before you get hit with it full blast. Cause we know that you can't take no more of that shit. That's it, it's over, no take it back. Shit savage, the way we let it go when we attack, bitch. Lashing out on anyone trying to come at us, we live for that shit. That's the type of action that happens to a side of hostile reaction. From the GBC, you know you fucked up when we laughing. While we sizing up these bitches for the slaughter, ride through like a marauder. Run you down, cause the car's stronger now. More than when you was at your best. Rest now, cause you know that we just getting started. Blessed with the will to survive, always ride or die. Hip hop will always live, long as the GBC's alive.
This is GBC, remakes and beats, doing what we please. Free the beats and smash up all enemies. This is GBC, remakes and beats, jumping MCs. Free the beat and beat up all enemy MCs. This is GBC, remakes and beats, doing what we please. Free the beats and smash up all enemies. This is GBC, remakes and beats, jumping MCs. Free the beat and beat up all enemy MCs.
In the words of someone that I once knew,
yeah,
choose the way you want to go,
okay,
and go in that direction.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's it. I'm not saying that's as simple as life is, but, you know, choose which way you want to go and figure out if I can get there, you know?
Yeah. You got to keep focused on the path.
Sometimes you run fast, sometimes you walk it slow.
Okay.
But as long as that's the direction in which you go.
Oh.
Welcome to episode 3.
Booth TV. Welcome back.
Season 2.
Season 2, episode 3.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
We got some treats for you in this episode.
We do. We do. We actually, on the season 1, we interviewed your younger brother as our first guest.
Yeah.
This time. All right.
We're Nate Dogg.
Do the older brother thing.
Nate Dogg. Nate the Unicorn.
Nate the Unicorn.
Oh, it was.
That's my fucking dude.
A good night.
Yeah,
a good time.
That was a good time.
I didn't get to go out with them, so it wasn't quite as in the right headspace, but.
Sad.
You know, it happens.
It happens.
We got some ghetto grub for you.
Yeah, of course. Of course.
Some What Would Willis Do?
What Would Willis Do?
Some fictitious statistics. And yeah, I had to look it
outtake,
up like 6 times.
Son.
Outtake, son.
Yeah.
And I had to look it up 3 times if you had to spell right. So don't
hey,
don't hate this spokesperson.
Don't mind the spelling right on any of this shit. We're not grammatically correct. All right.
Nor do we claim to be. I'm not a linguist, but I try to make a living with my mouth.
Yeah, well,
so just go figure that out.
You might want to clarify that, because there's plenty of ways to make a living with your mouth, bro.
I know, right? You see my knees are all cowed.
Probably be hooking people up in the streets, in the streets. But episode 3, we're gonna keep it rolling, and as always,
what are we gonna do? One of those us versus them freestyles?
Yeah, us versus them.
Here's up, us versus them 4.
At
pickthebeat,
yeah.
gmail.com.
You know, and you'll find
on
the
send
link.
It back to us.
Yeah, and you'll find a link to the beat that we use.
I'll send you out to all my friends and let them listen to it too.
But just to let you
I
know,
I have a lot of friends, but some of them will.
He's got a few friends.
I got a few friends.
I'm your friend.
I can count them on these hands and my toes.
Big toe. But anyways, the flow is called Flow Cheat, and the artist is called That Way.
That
so
Way.
Click
them
link
up on YouTube.
Yep, and in the description, click that link. Make sure you go over there. Subscribe, give them some likes.
And make sure you enjoy yourself.
Yeah, enjoy yourself. And if you
enjoy
haven't already, make sure that you subscribe to the Ghetto Booth on YouTube so you can stay updated every single week.
And you can find all our links on ghettobooth.com.
Yeah, ghettobooth.com.
All our social media.
Yeah, and we'll be touching that website.
Looking forward to seeing you guys there.
Absolutely. But for now, Paul, let's get into it.
All
us
right.
Versus them.
Here we go. No, like that joint for the us versus them.
You know it.
One, two.
Alright, ready?
Oh, that way? That's the name of the gun.
Yeah. How we do?
Not bad. When I was watching over some of these freestyle sessions that we've had, I realized that it seemed really mad. I never stopped swearing when I'm rapping it out in the fast notes. My mind was every direction. I keep me keep cheering. It's always out. Everybody's always laughing. It's on that pee. But I'm gonna try not to fucking swear in this freestyle.
Yeah, we gon' rip it up every time. We just don't give a rhyme that we spittin' is ripping these motherfucking critics when they try to come against the vision that we be lifting you to. Cause we do the shit for few views through YouTube, dude. Who would've knew that the ghetto booths and blaze dudes and blaze crews are maze fools who try to come with the get the game
cool podcast, yo.
Dropping it, so
Paulie B's gonna spit some flows, let you know that now you know you're gonna spell that I'm letting in your direction, and then, you know, I'm kinda stabbed at all the things I'm doing. You can't dissect it, cause I don't even know what the fucking lesson is. Oh, I messed up, I swore one time, now I got a confession to make.
Oh,
it was the first mistake I'm gonna make during this, but I don't care. Just give me the rake, I'll take it again.
I'm blessed with this shit so impressive. With every word that we let and lose, we just shredding anybody and letting these motherfuckers roll over us, never getting everything that we can. See, we don't have no plan, we just take over the shit one at a time till the world is in our hand. And you can't understand, you're perplexed, cause the plan is too complicated for you to stand.
Stand? Okay, hand in hand, man. Get up. The first step is to put your foot up and stand up and get up for what you want. That's why I'm here, I'm always gonna flaunt it and stand, and everything that I wanna prove to you is clear, man. And if you understand the glass, keep on glaring, man. I got two damn pants, and I'm aware that I can use them kind of for me when I fucking put my hands on you, dude.
See, the first thing to understand is the problem is the first thing, cause I just do the shit until I'm wearing the ring. You can say that he's a king. Crown the top of his head like a swing. Cause we doing everything, insane, spraying. All these motherfuckers, we ain't playing. Oh, we just laying like you down 6 feet, that's where your grave is. So we make a statement every time we stop raging.
Father, you said this was Woodstock 99. That was good.
Where don't cut fire?
Yeah, we would. Listen to this, Nathan. We left. We like had the intuition to leave before all that shit started.
Yeah, we left.
Yeah.
Might have something to do with the acid.
Really late Saturday night, early Sunday morning, depending on which side of the candle you were burning. But
yeah,
we ended up leaving. I kind of got up and I just like looked around. Everything was like,
what was that? What
was it? Was like kind of on fire, and I'm like, we're fucking out of here.
Yeah.
Oh, we left everything packed up, gone. And like, I've literally done every single drug I've ever done, except for cocaine at Woodstock, opium, mushrooms, everything. On that one, at that one fucking trusty, that one trusty festival in 99, but was it kind of, I knew it was good, it was fun, I rolled with it, but it was a time to go. They gave us, we did, we did some jail tags the day before, and we were walking back, what was it, who opened for Alanis Morissette?
Well, I don't remember.
But so Alanis Morissette is playing, what?
James Brown.
Oh no, maybe Rage Against the Machine. We saw Rage Against the Machine. My Alanis Morissette set. Cause I remember seeing that set. Alanis Morissette came on, and all these fucking jacked up steroid ass fucking ass. I mean, I didn't mind. They did the drug I didn't do at that festival, right? You know, like, wait till this shit gets off. Fucking Limp Bizkit is all next, and fucking Rage Against the Machine. Okay, I'm gonna go now.
Yeah.
You know, like I started walking back towards the campsite, like looking for everybody. It's like these guys. I mean,
I watched a documentary. And then they were like, hey, let's pass out candles to everybody. It'll be great.
No, was named the fucking was named the fucking sound tower, the Alamo.
Yeah.
Like, was named, and they would put this little, like, we need this little fucking, like, piece of paper that they told me to pull out of their, like, their journal. Like, a vision diary or whatever. It said, the Alamo on it.
Yeah.
I was like, all right, so, which side do you want? Are you like, you know, I don't think you're going to win this one.
Ain't no winning that battle.
No, not but
it was
thinking clearly.
No, it was like one of those crazy things. Well, Willis hooked us up with the tickets. He gave us a QP. He said, have fun, be safe. Use your intuition.
And
we didn't have to look for anybody. We came to, like, going back. It was kind of like a magnet that said it was, and anybody that we were with that would have been there for fucking Limp Bizkit that were about that. We just were too far to have left the site.
Well, and then they were saying that there was going to be a special guest at the end.
Yeah.
An unannounced artist, and then there never was.
It was Limp Bizkit. Then Metallica was on as we were packing our shit up.
Mm-hmm.
Metallica was sitting there playing as we were packing our shit up. Which is, like, just an interesting tale. I had the pictures from the Woodstock. The Woodstock, know, what do they call them? What do they call those fucking, the ones you get printed out and get in like this
little photo books.
But 35 millimeters? I have both of them. I have our half of them. I haven't saved. I'm going to put them in here after this right now. Right now, look for the fucking slideshow. Look for the pictures. From Woodstock.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
Do you suffer from asthma or any other respiratory ailment and have a hard time breathing sometimes? Who Pharma has you? Whenever you have a hard time breathing, and get your breath back. And that's a get your breath back guarantee. Brought to you by Boo Pharma.
That's a breathe easy you can guarantee. That's a breathe easy you can guarantee. That's a breathe easy you can guarantee. Breathe easy.
I went to the the Olympics.
Did you? For what?
For karate, for ninja stuff.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you win?
I mean, when I was, like, in high school.
Oh.
So it's a while ago, but yes.
I really...
Junior Olympics and stuff. Like, I have, like, trophies.
I really don't know any karate. Now I'm getting bashful.
I'm getting bashful.
I'm like, she knows karate. I'm like,
a little bit of stuff. See, like, it's been a long time, but.
Straight up, like, fucking.
You know?
Like, eight out of fucking nine times you do that, and worse, some people will leave you. And then they're looking at it. They get it. Then I don't write no karate when I do it, and it's not a thing. It's like, that looks sick. That's, keep going with that. Keep working on it.
I can show you a few things.
More fictitious statistics with Polly.
I'll take, son. Fictitious statistics. Wow. People that go to freshwater beaches, 20% go to sunbathe. That feels weird in my balls. An undertow can pull 3/4 of the total weight it would made the wave area based. A 2-foot undertow with a wave base. An undertow can pull 3/4 of the total weight. An undertow can pull.
Well, you want me to leave, Mickey?
It's not that. This ain't just blowing my balls. It's just, I'm getting out of breath. Like, it's like getting your dick checked by a girl with a mouth or something, of course. How is it over there working in the kitchen? You guys can just go in there, you bust it up. Like, you guys have got trucks. You just go to different locations.
Yeah.
And you get the trucks and a couple other shit, you guys go and set up on and take you to a separate location.
Day or two, depending on how big the kitchen is. But usually like...
2 days. 2 days. Day and a half.
Alright, so home was saying that, oh, but Chokey's your big, it's his big gig. The biggest gig he goes to, that he is on. How is it like setting up for that? Yeah. Like, what's the setup for that?
That's 2 solid days, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
2 solid days.
Setup.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we're there for... 14 days, like 12 or 14
3
days.
3 weeks.
Uh-huh. 2 weeks to take down.
Feeding. I mean, three meals 2 days a day.
Take down. You were here.
I'm fucking baked.
Dude, I was saying that junk fucking got me ripped out. You were here early, man. Like, you were here, like, you knew, like, you were, like, you hanging out for a day, and the next day you were taking shit, unloading the truck, and, like, getting big set up and stuff like that.
Yep.
You guys have a cleaning process you do, like when you take shit out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's already ready. It's already all cleaned up and ready. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like when you put stuff away, like that tastes
improved. Yeah, because we go through, we gotta clean everything before we pack it.
Yeah. So that's
you know, you can't pack it dirty.
Yeah, if you do that, it's fucking hard to get it off, right?
Yeah.
When you get back to the original location, the next place you're going.
You can blast that shit, son.
What?
Hit it with the fucking...
Oh, is that a drill? Is it? Is this blasting it? Is this,
It's like a drill.
Oh. With a little shovel thing on it?
It's like a grinder almost. A wire brush.
So,
It's really wild. But the nice thing, though, is with everything on cases, you know, just like musicians have, we have all of our equipment on, like, road cases.
Oh, yeah.
So then whenever we're done, we can just, like,
who rolled this fucking joint to smoke a flare
rack? Put the lids on.
Yeah.
Clamp it up and roll it out.
Yeah, they labeled. They labeled by number.
Is they're all numbered. For sure.
Is it not
and they're all
code?
Labeled. You know, they're labeled of what
our
it is.
Very serious
about labeling.
Yeah, it's not like a secret code. You got to learn the secret code.
You should put the weight on the label.
See this? We're talking
improvements. Improvements. That's cool. There's a process, right? Now we have digital proof.
That's the other piece of information that should be on the label.
Oh, it's just like
it's how much it weighs.
Yeah. Put in a piece of paper. We got put in like we can fill a piece of paper.
Yeah, because we have a little laminator, that we travel with too, so that we can label all of our shit.
Yeah.
And just make a new one.
You have like two crates that kind of label similar. If you have the weight on it, it'd be the difference between.
Yeah, this is the prior, this is the it would just be another piece of information that would be helpful.
Yeah.
Okay. While packing things, because while packing the trucks, like we can't have the trucks overweight.
Can't have trucks overweight.
You know.
I've heard of this.
And
I've
everything
heard of
is heavy.
This happened.
Yep.
Everything right. we own.
Especially if somebody flakes cleaning this shit up.
You know.
Nobody flakes their things.
No, I know that's the point, but
so much stuff.
Yeah.
And it's even all right, so every crate, say every crate has an extra pound in it. You have an extra fucking
sometimes,
pound
like, in between, like, the weeks, like, whenever we're serving, like, mm-hmm. in the show days,
yeah.
like, I'll just stop and I'll, like, look around and I'll be like, oh my god, there's so much shit.
Everywhere.
Like, dispersed throughout this kitchen, and I'm like, we have to pack up. At the end, it's okay. We all know where it goes.
It
all has
like
a place.
Thing.
Like
it
it'll be fine, you know.
And it's you guys. So where everybody being from, like all of the country, pretty much,
mm-hmm.
right? Do you have different crews when you go to different shows?
We have a core crew,
really.
But then there's like if
we
a
like to
shows,
stay together.
Yeah.
But sometimes we overlap shows, and so we have to like split the crew up.
Okay.
But we like to stay together.
Yeah.
You know, like we'll do a full like 16-hour day
mm-hmm. yeah.
all together.
Yeah.
Like we won't do a day shift, night shift,
yeah.
or anything mm-hmm. else.
And so you're there from the beginning, you're
yeah.
there at the end.
Yep.
It's just smoother
pretty,
that
that's
way.
That's pretty cool. So basically, this is your crew. I basically made a lot of your crew right now.
Yeah.
That
yeah.
was like over the last
this
weekend.
This is about like a quarter of us?
Oh, it was a small
maybe?
Festival.
Yeah, it was a small festival.
So maybe what you guys do.
I would say
half,
but
yeah.
I don't know, maybe
no,
half.
Just, was it easier? The people that was easier for them to get here? Because I know like some people get to fly, some people would take the train out. You know.
This was mostly, I think, I was the only like far, far away person.
You were?
California, yeah.
Yeah, you probably drove a truck from California.
Drove
right?
a truck, yeah.
And me and Caitlin and Jules drove from West Virginia.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that was like 11 hours.
Yeah, and they compensate
yeah.
you guys? And they take care of you
yeah,
guys?
Yeah,
I mean,
travel, you know.
Yeah.
That's always yeah. taken care of. And
mm-hmm.
our boss is really fair, you know. Like
that's
wants
awesome.
He wants us there because he knows that we're going to take care of things. And
honestly, from what I've talked to me, I can tell we trust
stuff.
You guys as like a crew. As like a unit?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, if not,
yeah.
not just you, how many other units like you guys are there? Do you have like two or three of them?
Two or three what?
Like you guys are the crew. Are you guys the crew for him? Or
mm-hmm.
you just said he brought a couple more, big, heavy duty,
he's
going to
be getting more semi-trucks.
Yeah. Because you have other crews that are doing different.
Yeah,
we're starting
when we did like the bigger show, there's probably like 30 of us,
yeah,
if not more.
Yeah,
you know, because we'll have two lines going instead of just one line going. You
yeah.
know, we'll be feeding
yeah.
people and everything
and,
else.
Yeah.
So
when we double up the lines, it gets a little crazy. It's like two.
Yeah, but I kind of like it better that way. Whenever we're nonstop and
hey,
we have like constant line of people and everything else, because. Then as soon as you know it, it's like dinner time, and you're like, holy shit, like, I get to go home in an hour.
Yeah,
you know
wait,
what
no,
I mean?
You know what's next.
Instead of whenever
yeah.
it's like super slow, and we have like little people coming in, and they're just kind of like standing around fucking busy work.
Oh, yeah.
Dragging the day long.
There's almost a lot of this show. Just
yeah.
The numbers
you
are
so saying
low.
You didn't
the
get, you didn't
like
get
it
expected.
Better whenever
mm-hmm.
A lot of people.
But wasn't it like more? I thought there was a lot more people went to this one than has gone recently.
Yeah.
In the past couple years. So I think with those estimated numbers, like, they just wanted to make sure there was not food for anybody that would eat.
For you, I give my life to you. What a life, what a with the right nights, make all your dreams come true. The nights they got to
got you here. All the love that we got to give.
Say what you need, and I'll be right here for you.
Take
them
over
that shit. Some asshole cuts you off, not hitting you, and smashing in the car beside you, taking them both off the road.
What will we do?
Well, I'd probably first say thank you, God. And second, I'd probably pull over, call state police, and be there as a witness to say what kind of an asshole this asshole was.
And that's what we'll do.
You're a Walmart trying to get some undergarments, like underwear and socks. You're bending down in the bottom shelf to grab a pair of socks, a set of socks you like, and some dude comes and smacks you in the ass really fucking hard.
What will we do?
Well, I know what I'd probably do, but I would hope that I would maybe knock this bitch right off his fucking feet, kick him in the nuts, and walk away like nothing happened. But I would just probably get up and walk away like nothing happened.
And that's what we'll do.
You're on a vacation with some of your buddies, and it's your turn to make the meal.
What will we do?
Well, it depends. Is it takeout? Or probably I would have known how to make dinner and make a tinfoil dinner. Matt, potatoes, some beef, carrots, onion, whatever. But I'd probably just be simple, just make tinfoil cooking.
And that's what we'll do. And that's what we'll do. And that's what we'll do.
Ours hit snobs sometimes. They want like fucking. Yeah. They want another girl.
You always hit your like different types of people. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
When you have the artists and the bands coming through?
Sometimes. Yeah. I mean, like, usually people are like really super nice, but like every now and then you get somebody that like comes up in the. Like, Jules had someone come up and like give her his order. Of, like, what he wanted.
And it wasn't anything
like,
he
like, walked up to her, and he was like, oh, hey, I want, like, a hamburger, and, like, whatever, and, like, this and that. And she was like, what do you think this is?
Right?
Like, a drive-thru?
Yeah. the food you guys put out, it was good. It's like, it's killer, you know what I'm saying?
It's bomb shit.
If anybody's going hungry at one of these things, what you guys cook in there? Mm-hmm. Especially when
they're in Danville.
It's not like they give you like a tip or like a fucking, you don't give them a bill or anything for it. You know, just
I did get a $10 tip.
Well, I don't know.
The dude's like, do you guys accept tips? I was like, we love weed.
We seen that someone came out with t-shirts and stuff. You guys got all the t-shirts and stuff. It's good to meet people from the bands. I understand people that are.
It's nice and just to make friends and meet new people. And
I work in the kitchen, so I don't really get to talk to too many people.
Yeah,
I get to do eggs today.
Yeah, and I'm up front. I'm on the lawn, so like, I meet everybody.
Yeah.
Green people. Everybody.
I'm like talking to like, you know, I'm like.
You see the same people every day.
Well, that's not awesome. All
three times a day.
Yeah.
You know?
Good people. Different people all the time.
Usually.
You got to make sure you can travel around to different places.
Yeah, but you see familiar faces, though.
He was saying that. He's running into somebody kind of sometimes that he grew up with in high school.
Yeah.
He ran into other shows, other places, kind of didn't realize how he was familiar with him, didn't quite remember.
Mm-hmm.
And he wasn't, I don't think, they never had a conversation like they knew each other. So the other guy who was kind of probably could feel the same thing.
Yeah.
You know, and that's it happens, but it's like,
crazy. I mean, Caitlin, I think that she may have met a distant cousin of hers
at
the show.
Hmm. Oh, that's cool.
Just from, like, talking.
John Denver lived next door to us when I was in high school.
No way.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, Caitlin, one of the trash guys. The one that looks like Jason Momoa. Oh.
Where's
that? They think that they have the same, like, the same ancestors.
Remember,
West Virginia.
One of our good friends lived across the street from Steven Tyler when I'm trick or treating in his house, and we're fucking knocking, and like this sweet ass fucking chick, and we think it was Liv Tyler, one of the fucking dogs, we didn't fucking know. They brought fucking hand out wax lips.
Yeah.
Was that candy treat? But thanks to we like left, and I don't ever recall being excited about getting wax lips on Halloween, but. if you know, with everything with all lemons, like, you didn't really tell who it was, but they're taking trick or treat. The lights went on and off.
Yeah, nice house.
You're wearing my Joe Grandma's.
Jenny's here.
Not yet.
Well, it is, I think, because you guys chatting it out and stuff.
Back of pineapple.
Hey, cool TV. Way. Make sure you guys subscribe. Yeah, that was fun.
That was fun. I mean, I want to give a shout out to Nate, my dude. It's my fucking dude.
It's my brother.
Yeah, and his little catering group, they did a killer job.
Oh, is Bree in this one?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, so it's working with Bree.
Yeah,
and, you know.
And they, and, you know, they were working at the Levitate Festival. They do a killer job, and
they
really
cater
excited.
The work crew and the bands.
Yeah, they do a lot. They do
a lot, and they're fast, they're quick, and they're efficient at it.
Yeah, they got they got a good little team going on.
Plus, I want to say thanks for Willie.
Yep. Oh, always thanks to Willie.
Because you know, we always want to know what will Willis do.
Yeah.
And we have a gift for you guys, and it's one of our brother's band's live performances from back in the day that we'll be playing.
That entry show. That last show.
The last entry show.
And a funny note about this show, even though you don't see it in the video, Polly actually kind of got into a little spat with a dude who was being an asshole in the mosh pit.
And I was screaming at him. His buddy came up and hit me in the face behind him.
Yeah.
And it was fun. It was fun. It was a fun event.
It was a fun event.
Means.
And, you know, I was there back in the day.
I mean, it was like everybody that was there back in the day was there at the last show, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know, we'd be smoking that Tanqueray, throw them up in the air. You got that weed, you got this blunted, like, mustard vest, like, Grey Poupon.
Yeah. Yeah, so, you know, and always make sure that you go to the Ghetto Booth on Facebook. You can go to Booth TV at Facebook, follow us there.
We got join the group.
We got
like
the
it, share it, hate it. Why don't you report us for doing some dumb shit and get me suspended for 24 hours again, you fucking pricks.
No, don't do that.
I mean, all right.
But, you know, and make sure you come on over, like, share, subscribe to the YouTube page so you can keep up with all the new episodes.
And if you're doing something cool, come on, chill with you.
Yeah.
We'll watch your podcast, look at your little posts, your little reels and shit that you be doing.
Yeah, absolutely. We
I got two points of fingers, and both of them are for liking and sharing your shit.
That's right. How we do, right? But, you know, until the next time, you know, join us for episode 4. But we're going to leave you with the entropy show.
Like a blast.
And it's going to be good. So until next time, get a booth. We out.
Peace.
We're all better with us. Even with you. We sucked a lot. I guess we're all right a lot. But two things stand. This being our last show. First off, we've sucked a lot. Sucked when we began. But...